Hello. This is Shiva again and Jonathan, aka the Matrixers. Let's move on to the next part about question, the light trap. Correct. Welcome to part 4 of the questions and answers on the topic of light traps. As Shiva says, and we are happy that you are here again and at least those who still have these questions. We already answered many of them in the comments. Could you read it too? But we keep going. We got a lot of questions. So I would say how many were there? Do you have that in mind? 50, 60 approximately? Yes, 50, 60, that's a lot. So for the fact that these are the first videos, there is already a keen interest in the subject of the Matrix. Whether to leave them, how to leave them, and everything related to the Matrix. Of course, we are very happy that you are so open and reflected so well and are critical of the whole thing. Yes, and what is the first question? So the next question. Is there a way to see through the illusion, if there is one? And can we turn off the Matrix here on Earth? So when it comes to switching off the Matrix, we need a critical mass that you have to overcome. Definitely yes, definitely a critical mass. So that the more people believe in it, the stronger it becomes. How should I put it? The clearer the side effects. Yes, and that energy level increases. Yes, the energy level rises and at some point people's consciousness rises to the point where they see through it. The principle, the dualistic principle, and the more expanded one is in consciousness, the more one sees through the illusion that the first part of the question. That means when you are in dissociation, i.e., in a heightened state, and then you can see through the illusion better. Correct. Dissociation is the be-all and end-all when it comes to this and of course also when it comes to expanding consciousness. Yes, what else is included in the question? Well, do they want to shut down the Matrix? Yes, shut down the Earth Matrix. It's possible, but you would have to know where the button is. Or have enough people. So there's also a long story behind the machine that keeps the whole Matrix going. But we'll explain that in another video. Next question. The dead really consciously choose whether they want to be president or assassin. Well, maybe not president directly. Because I don't think they would choose that voluntarily if they were murderers. Yes. So many believe in the principle of karma and guilt. I want to choose something to make amends. Yes. I think the point is that if you just want to leave the Matrix or when you die and then go back into the light, you can be shown in a certain state of consciousness what is possible on Earth, what you can achieve. And there, in this state, you can also see that it would be quite possible to even become president, which of course is not that easy, but within this state, with which you are supposed to be lured back into the Matrix, it shows many options that you have. Yes, I would say so too. And it depends on the level of consciousness of the deceased what he chooses to be in the next life. Yes, I would see it that way too. The next question. Does God exist? This is a question of definition. The creator God of the Matrix. The primal source. Is there both? So it depends on which God we're talking about here. First of all, there is the biblical God from the Old Testament. so we're pretty sure it was actually a god. This means that mankind does not have a history of creation, only a genetic history of creation. And that represents the Bible. And then there is the original source. We separated from it, but not separated in the sense of we separated, but I saw that we flew out of the original source as sparks of light. And these beings created the universe. So the source of all being after all? Yes, you have to imagine that the original source would be the original God, you could almost say. And so trillions of aspects have detached themselves from this primordial God. They then swarmed out in all directions, and some of them just created the material universe that we know. You could say so? Yes. I saw that once, at my interdimensional school. That was pretty crazy, how all creation came into being or happened. Yes. It felt like remembering it like it was yesterday. Was very strong. Yes, great. The next question is, why is there no warning from God or angels not to go into the light? Do you want quick answers? Why is there no advance warning to sign the contract with telecom? From the telecom people? I think you have to see that God doesn't judge, and that who lets us play here on earth, he also lets us go in here because we want to experience it here. We want to play and watch. One has to consider. Okay, good. Those who created the Matrix may not have been lying about the Matrix when they lured us here. But honestly, so, you may have been completely honest, but you weren't sincere. You didn't tell us everything. What you get yourself into. And that's exactly what they're not going to tell us. This is where you come out. Yes. So first think about which God is meant. So the primeval God is clear. He doesn't judge at all. For him, that's just what his souls all do who have been split off from him. Everyone was only his own master or wife, and of course, angels and God. That sounds like a system within the Matrix again. And in principle, I would say that the angels, who are part of the dualistic Matrix system, of course want to maintain the whole system and of course support it in their diplomatic way. Of course, there are also those who want to help, otherwise we wouldn't know. We've seen it too. For example, the higher self showed me. And that is God. But we are part of God. So it is already shown to you. It is not presented to you directly on the plate. You have to put yourself in a state and then you'll be shown it. It's already been said, somewhere too. You just have to want it. Want to see. Yes. I agree with that. Yes to the next question. Yes. What is there to say about the electronic traps that capture souls? So the electronic traps. Yes. Well, we must of course remember that traps are seen in quotes. We decided to call it falling. The light trap, of course, to push it a little bit, to make it clear to everyone that you can also see it as a trap. That doesn't mean it's 100% a trap, though. But everyone has to judge for themselves. These electronic light traps, for example, or aesthetic traps mostly consist of beautiful light that has a beautiful charisma of love, courage, and God, or on an acoustic level that of course produces beautiful music or beautiful tones and singing. And that, of course, attracts a lot of curious souls. And of course they are interested in learning more. You can see it as advertising. Yes, actually it is advertising. It's advertising. Yes, it really is these light traps that are advertising. According to the motto, look how beautiful it is here. How great you can feel here. What kind of beautiful music there is and beautiful lights and what I don't know. It's an advertisement. Yeah, next question. Why do some people not see light when they die? Yes, from experience, I know from relatives that it is actually seldom the case that some simply do not see the light. And they think that nothing comes after death and that we die and are then worm food. But why is this actually the case? Yes, I think that they, well, you get where they landed too. For example, on my out-of-body journeys I discovered so-called voids. These are really areas that you can go into by not seeing anything, hearing nothing, perceiving nothing. But you hear your own thoughts. At least. Well, I already know that. I then call them voids. I think maybe one or the other ended up there. Maybe then. The light does not always have to be visible straight away. I would say. Yes, I don't know that at all. I don't know. The next question. Can one incarnate at any time or only from birth? Depending on. So either you can come into the body for birth, much later, or much, much later. That's called a walk-in. Yes, well, I define walk-in as meaning that coma patients offer their bodies to someone else. I would call that a walk-in. But there are also possibilities that you can even be thrown from one incarnation straight into the next and start there as an adult. So I've experienced this before. I once saw that, in the course of my reincarnations, that this happened to me once. And sometimes the information that one allegedly experienced simply comes to life as a download. You get your own past as an information download. You didn't really live it and then you went into your body at, say, 40 and think you've already lived for 40 years. Yes, and then the whole memory pool of school, parents, job, training is simply uploaded and then you are 40 years old and you think you have actually lived through the 40 years? Yes, that is also possible. So it depends on the souls which experiences they want to have. Sometimes they want to be part of the whole birthing process and see what's that like. Or those who have lived a long time just do a walk-in after 30 years or so.